How is social media shaping up in the election 2012 so far this year?
What it is doing is defining the set of stories that rise to the level of national prominence that then ripple out through the sort of political terrain and force the candidates to respond or have some position on it.
What challenges do you think that social media presents to the candidates?
If there's a whisper campaign or a bunch of charges being leveled at you that aren't true on social media, who do you attack? Who do you sort of direct your refutation to, right? And more importantly, to the extent that you begin to address it, right, we actually know from research in psychology that denials had a tendency to reinforce the initial belief, right? So if you start going around because a bunch of people are sending stuff on social media saying you're not born in the United States, and you say, I was born in the United States, and you go in front of the cameras and you say that over and over, all that's going to do is make people think, maybe you weren't born in the United States because you keep insisting that you are. Every American of a certain generation is going to be totally overexposed by the time that they run for office, right? Because every infelicity, every poor adolescent judgment, every stupid college prank is going to be captured in evidence on the internet. So at a certain point, we're going to have to figure out how to deal with that. There's going to be a question that we all have to kind of wrestle with about how do we incorporate that into what disqualifies people. And I think if it becomes disqualifying, then that's going to disqualify everyone, because everyone's going to have, particularly the sort of generation just below me, is going to have stuff that is going to be up on the internet and will have been shared that in another era would be seen as disqualifying. But I think we're going to have to sort of expand the kind of category of things that we think are okay and still run for president. That's already happened with drug use, right? There's a period in time in which admitting previous drug use was essentially disqualifying. And that's no longer the case, right? So I think there's actually a similar trajectory with whatever kind of sort of youthful social media documented infractions there might be.